It's Speed Laughs, the comedy podcast for people with short attention spans who don't know how to,
I tell you, you've got to stop talking like me. It's driving me mad. Well, I will if you'll stop talking like me first.
Now, ladies, there must be some way to solve this problem. If I could only tell you apart. Oh, dear.
That's simple, Doctor. One of them has a wedding ring on her finger.
Oh, of course. You must be Anne. I should have looked at your hands.
Then why didn't you do that in the first place, you silly ass?
Yes, you must be Anne, all right. Now then, Miss Maroney, if you'll allow me to turn the dial on the voice simulator again, we'll try to get your voice back to normal. There. How's that?
Gee, thanks, chum. That feels swell. I guess now I can... Say, what's the matter with me voice now? Say, listen, you goofy mug. Can't you get this gadget working the way it's supposed to? You're getting me awful sore with this malarkey, see?
Never mind your voice, Rose. We've got a murder case to solve, remember?
Say, that's right.
I'm sorry, Miss Maroney. It looks like I can't fix it right now. You'll just have to accept that you won't be able to talk in your normal voice for a while yet. Now, tell me, what is all this about a murder?
Well, you see, I'm in the gumshoe racket. A little while ago, I get a ring on the Amici from a fellow I used to know named Lord Stitchington. He was...
Oh, Lord Stitchington, oh, yes. I knew him quite well. We used to play cricket together in the old days, you know.
Is that so? Maybe you can help us find him, then. Anyway, Stitchy rings me up, and he says somebody was bumped off. I ask him who it was, and he says it was himself. All of a sudden, I heard a gat go off in Stitchy's croak, see? Then another voice comes over the wire and tells me it was just a recording of Stitchy being croaked before. I tried to figure out who the other mug on the line was, but then somebody bumps him off. So now I got two moiters to figure out, and they both got me buffaloed and how. You get me?
Oh, I say, that sounds dreadful.
Yeah, the moiters.
No. I mean your voice. I can't understand a word you're saying.
I'll put it to you in plain English, Doc. Two fellas bit the dust, and I gotta get a handle on who done it, see? If you can help me dope out what kind of a joint they was in when they got croaked, it could mean a lot of dough for both of us, see?
Oh, dear. It's only getting worse. I wish I'd never invented that thing.
Doc, you gotta listen to me. I'll say it one more time. Two mugs gotta get to their domes, and now they're stiffs. And I got an idea the mug that done it might take a powder to beat the rap, so I gotta hot-foot it after him pronto, or it's coitins. Savvy?
Oh, yes. I understood you that time, all except one part of it.
What part?
The part after you said, Doc, you've got to listen to me.
Oh, well, wise guy, eh? Don't go high-hatting me, bud.
All right, I'll explain it. Two people were killed, and Rose wants you to help us figure out who did it.
Well, why didn't you say that in the first place?
That's what I was saying. Can I help it if you don't talk good English like me?
Won't we think that if you knew Lord Stitchington so well, you could help us find out where he lived? Then we could find the body, you see?
Oh, I don't think I could be of much help there.
Why not?
Well, as I said, I only knew Lord Stitchington in the old days, many years ago. I haven't seen him in a good, 25 years. How would I know where he was living?
So we've got to find his address somehow.
I say we do. If there's a murderer on the loose out there who's just killed two fellas, we gotta find him. I'm sure he's awful dangerous.
Wait a minute. How did your voice change again? I didn't even touch the dial.
Consarn it. I think it's done gone haywire on us. I told you this doggone thing ain't no good.
Wait a minute. I think I've got an idea how we can fix Rose's voice.
Yeah?
Well, the voice simulator is connected to your throat by a wire.
Yeah?
So if you want to speak in your normal voice, why don't you just disconnect the wire like this?
Oh, yes. Oh, I should have thought of that in the first place.
What? You mean it was that simple? I could have stopped talking in those ridiculous voices hours ago, and you just didn't think of doing that? You f***ing stupid, incompetent son of a...
Oh, I say, you'd better start the theme music fast.
Will Rose ever learn to control her temper? Will Dr. Onymous ever be more responsible with his inventions? Will Rose ever figure out who killed Lord Stitchington? Will Rose ever remove this voice simulator from my throat?
Will Rose ever figure out where Lord Stitchington lived? On how to find the body? Will I ever stop talking in this silly voice? Will I be fired from the announcers' union for not sounding dignified enough?
I told you I'd get even with you for making fun of me, you lousy.
Will the Daniel Clute ever be able to tell the difference between a crocodile and an alligator? Will the show ever make any sense? Tune into the next episode of SpeedLaughs and find out.
That was the sixth episode.
And you too.
In the third series of SpeedLaughs, a short podcast for short people with short attention spans, written by Andrew Gilmore and featuring Andrew Gilmore, Dick Lee, Martha Michael, and Joe McCann. We hope you enjoyed it, and if you didn't, who cares?